Hey everybody, I'm Jerry Mitchellark, and I finally have an automobile to do what I want with. And I've always shot into them. I never had a chance to shoot out of them. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to take my everyday carry gun, my M&P, and what I have in it for ammo is the Hornady 135 Critical Duty. It's what I carry. The FBI tested it and they said it's barrier blind. So I'm going to play with it a little bit today. We're going to shoot some automotive glass with it out of my carry gun, short barrel, and see how it affects the bullet flight. So we're going to set up targets and we're going to go through the procedures and do it. From what I was told, I've never done this before, the correct method, of course, is to make contact with the glass and bring it back just a little bit. And the idea of that is if you do shoot, it's going to carry most of the splatter and the glass spalling with the muzzle blast through the glass. The windscreen, of course, is a laminated glass. It's going to be harder to shoot through. It's going to take more rounds to get a window of opportunity to shoot through. The side glasses, of course, are tempered. They're thinner, and they pretty much shatter. I'm thinking one shot, and they're going to be pretty much gone. So I'm going to start with a full mag. I'm going to dress up best I can safety-wise, and we're going to go ahead and take it out of the holster, make a contact to the windscreen, press off a single round, and just try to take a look at the target. I've got an aiming point on it, and the reason for that is I've also been told there's a lot of bullet deflection that takes place when you shoot through a windscreen because of the angle and the hardness. So I'm going to test that also. I'm going to touch off one round and we're going to take a look at the target, then I'm going to get back in and I'm going to do another burn on it and see what it looks like. So it ought to be fun. I'm going to dress up. I've got a lot more equipment on than what I need. I just, safety first. I don't want to be that guy bleeding out on the range. So here we go. Okay, that was kind of exciting, but let's take a look at it. I made a contact with the glass, brought it back a little bit, made the shot. I was aiming right here, so I had about 5 inch worth of deflection there. That's pretty interesting, you know. That's that angle of that glass does some weird things to a bullet. Yeah, so I'm gonna get back in there. I'm gonna get about another 6 to 8 rounds through it and see what it looks like. See if I can work a hole in it, make a straight shot. Okay, we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna touch the windscreen, bring it back a little bit, make sure the slide's not hitting it. I'm gonna put a 6-shot rapid fire on that target, same point of aim, and see where they go. So here we go. So it's kind of obvious the first bullet does all the work, and the rest of them there, I was able to keep it with the same point of aim, and they went pretty much directly into the target. I'm sure some of them were touching the glass. The hole is probably 3 times as bigger, but it looks like once you start a hole in the windscreen, it's a lot easier for that following projectile to hit the target relatively straight. So we're going to try something different. Okay guys, what I'm going to do here, I've got a target off the quartering side here on the front windscreen. We'll put 2 on that one, then I'm gonna shoot through the side glass and see what happens there. It's gonna be 4 shots total out of the M&P pistol, so let's see what happens. All right. Clear. So So what I tried to do there was shoot more rapid fire like you would in a real situation. I purposely moved the gun a little bit so it would make different entrance holes into the windscreen. They came in, of course, two different spots. One hit close. I was doing a little bit of rapid fire there. One hit close to where I was aiming. The second one was a little bit high after it went through the windscreen. And that just gives you an idea of when you're shooting through an object that's not parallel to your target, what can happen to the bullet. The sound level in that was 124.4, so it was pretty intense. And on the side glass, what I wanted to do was shoot as rapid fire as I could. And when I came to the target, it stopped a little bit left of center. And I just went ahead and shot two shots kind of rapid fire to see what would happen. And you can see these hit pretty much straight on. The glass is pretty much straight up and down. But you notice this tempered glass, when you shoot it, it just starts to leave. It actually came back on me in that driver's side over there. So if I was contact distance from that side glass and pull the trigger, you're gonna get a lot of glass on you. So something to think about. But anyway, it was a lot of fun. I learned a little bit, made a little noise, got it, get some.